must try to ignore that it's painful in that love. What's love got to do?
Sport, wherever they live, whatever they do, whatever they believe.
Like meeting them, how much fun they had.
Video games make you
want to kill it. Not just for London and the top 3 lanes, one of the ways that really does come alive.
You will remember it for the rest of your life.
Editors, they're both.
I've got cause to be, there's a name for it, there's a phrase that fits, but whatever the reason, to do it for me, oh, what's love got to do, it's got to do it.
With a capacity of 80,000, this is the place where many athletes' dreams will be fulfilled. But for those not lucky enough to be competing, this is what it feels like to do a lap.
To make an Olympic champion takes 8 Olympic finalists. To make an Olympic finalist takes 80 Olympians. To make an Olympian takes 202 national champions.
London's mayor tells VIPs to take the train to the Olympics rather than clog up the Special Games Lanes road network. Two bosses pledge that the threat of strike action on the underground rail system will be resolved by the time the millions of athletes and spectators arrive in the UK.
London Mayor Boris Johnson urged Olympic dignitaries on Monday to take public transportation during this summer's games rather than chauffeur-driven limousines on specially designated lanes to help avoid raising the ire of log-jammed Britons. Some athletes failed to arrive for their events in Atlanta 1996. That brought about the Olympic Route Network, ORN, for London. Londoners have also been warned they face delays on the underground rail network at certain hotspots during peak times.
And the best, most sensible way of getting around London in games time is to go by public transport. And I'm certainly going to be doing that myself.
Transport officials launched a Get Ahead of the Games campaign on Monday, including a website and Twitter to help the public plan journeys. Workers on London's underground rail network, known as the Tube, have just turned down an Olympic bonus offer. But London's Transport Commissioner is confident strike threats will be resolved.
We're expecting a lot of our staff to work longer, differently and harder. And those are reasonable things to pay people more money for.
Hendy said London will struggle, unlike some other Olympic cities.
So the transport networks are old, the road system is old, we don't have the opportunity of five-lane highways as they did in Beijing. So we've got to plan much more carefully to ensure that we can get ticket holders to their events.
Many taxi drivers are threatening to go on holiday during the Games, fearing gridlock on the streets.
I'm going to Spain. Get out of the way. I can't stand it. It's enough with the traffic now, you know, without going, you know, when the Olympics start. Can you imagine what it's going to be like? Chaos.
The two main tube lines affected will be the Central and the Jubilee lines, which both go to the Olympic Park. Workers at Canary Wharf, where millions use the Jubilee line, are not confident.
No confidence whatsoever. It's already pretty disastrous when there's a minor delay, so, you know, the numbers they're talking about, I don't see how it can possibly not affect the routes.
The ORN is shaping up as a major irritant to Londoners who already have to endure long delays on the capital's narrow streets.
But whatever the reason, you do it for me. Oh.